next on the God Squad.
You scared me a little bit.
Do you know the Lord Jesus, the man of this house, shall die today if he chooses to go with the deceiver?
Gotcha. I really appreciate y'all. He's been packing this around for a long, long time.
All I know is, if you have to go, my prayers will go with you.
I don't know how long they're planning on staying or anything. I don't know. I just want you to remember my brother's day, though. Just remember me.
I want to go to heaven. I want to do what's right. I want to do what's right towards your family, too.
Bless them, Lord. Well, I will meet up with them.
You all hit my car and made y'all pay for it.
I told you all that the Lord told me to tell you. What these things mean, I do not know. But I know that they're true because they come from the Lord.
Always seem to get right in my way, but in my hour of desperation, he's always by my side. If I keep my eyes on him, I can overcome the night. Morning's coming just inside. Every fear and doubt will surrender to the light. Morning's coming, hold on tight. If you just trust in him, you'll make.
I can't tell you that I have.
Kind of desolate.
Bless them, Lord. Well, I will meet up with them. If that be them, Lord.
Nothing around here. I don't know why anybody even want to live in a place like this. Oh, look, angel.
Well,
three, we were led here by the Lord.
I thank God for sending you. Been praying for a long time that somebody can
someone come here?
Sure.
I want you to know before we start that we're here to help.
Well, I sure been praying that somebody, that the Lord send somebody here to help me.
What kind of help do you need?
It's my husband. He's been searching for some scriptures and stuff. He's been praying about and everything.
Who are you, folks? My name's John Abraham.
Hi.
I'm Craig.
My name's Elijah.
Why'd you do the talking?
I guess you're probably wondering why we're here. Why don't you tell him, Elijah?
The thought did cross my mind.
See, we were led here by the Lord, and when we come to your house, your wife said that you were going through some problems and needed some scriptures to help you. And since we're all Christians well-versed in the Bible, we would like to try to help.
Speak for yourself, I ain't well-versed.
My wife, she thinks all the answers are there and stuff, but I don't know.
Your answers is there.
That's right, buddy. I don't know all the answers, but I know that they're all there. That's the reason why we got to study the Bible and read the answers, and then we know what they are.
Show ourself approved.
Instead of show ourself approved.
Like he said, he's not well versed.
I know people mean well in the Bible, like that and stuff, but more than just something, I need some peace in my mind and heart about something.
So you're searching.
So you're searching. Okay. Well, once you're free indeed, once you know Jesus.
The Bible says, ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek, and ye shall find.
Hey, man, why don't you go up and get your electronic Bible, dude? I'll be guaranteed that there's some stuff in here.
I'll be back.
If you're looking for answers in the scriptures, you're looking in the right place.
That's right, man. I can guarantee you that.
I don't know about the kind of answers I need.
What's John done with that?
See, all you gotta do is believe in your heart and confess with your mouth, and you'll be saved, and you'll be free indeed, set free indeed by Jesus. Once you
seeking the Lord Himself.
Have you ever been responsible for somebody's life before?
We're responsible for somebody's life if we don't tell them about the Lord.
When you're a minister, you're responsible to the people that you preach to.
Yeah. Well, I'm not a minister, but I like to.
It's not the same thing.
Are you talking spiritual death, or are you talking physical death?
Thanks to me. The family.
Well, sounds like the phone's ringing or something somewhere.
I'm gonna go in.
Nice cozy fire.
I really appreciate y'all. He's been packing this around for a long, long time.
Hello? Hello, Owen? It's Fred.
Hey, Fred. What have you been into, buddy? I was just kind of thinking about you today.
Sitting right here being depressed. It's his birthday.
Yeah. Kind of thought about that today, being his birthday. Anything I can do for you?
Yes, there sure is. There sure is something you can do for me today. I'm thinking we can go to the bar and sit around and talk. Reminisce about old times. I think that's what he probably would do if he's around. Be a good memory to him.
Well, right now, I've got some company right now. I don't know how long they're planning on staying or anything.
Well, if you got something more important, go ahead, buddy. If you got something more important, my brother, I just want you to remember my brother's day, though. Just remember me. And I guess I'll just sit here by myself then, and I'll remember brother by myself then, maybe. Just sit here. I don't know if I can go on living like this, buddy. Without my brother, I ain't got nobody to talk to.
Oh, no, that ain't what I was talking about. No, I wasn't saying it was not important, but I've got guests and stuff right now. Maybe if you just let me know what time you got in mind, we might be able to work it out.
Well, I tell you what, it sure will mean the whole world to me if you'll go about 4 o'clock. I'll be there to pick you up.
Should be able to make it by 4 o'clock. We'll try to be there. We'll have to let you go now. I'm going to get back to my guests.
That stupid fellow will blame anything.
A little bit.
Do you know the Lord Jesus?
Oh, of course. That's what I'm doing right now. As a witnessing to somebody.
The man of this house shall die today if he chooses to go with the deceiver, but shall live forever if he chooses to stay.
How do you know the man of this? Hey, wait a minute.
What's taking you so long?
Just talking to this guy.
What guy?
There was a guy standing here.
He must have gone.
Kind of scared me a little bit.
Why, what big, kind of fellow was it?
Big tall guy, I don't know. Strange looking. I don't know. Have you seen my Bible?
Yes, it's in the trunk. I put it in there with the new clothes I bought you.
Makes sense. You got the key with you?
Lord, strengthen my brethren. Bless them, Lord.
We're here to listen and not be judgmental.
That's right. We really would like to help.
What kind of help can you give somebody when you're responsible for a man's life? Actually, he got him killed.
How exactly did it happen?
Well, he was out on assignment. He was sent to guard the back of where we suspected him to be at. And I don't know exactly, but I think I may have just sent him right into an ambush.
But did you know that that he'd be ambushed if he went?
No.
Then you're not responsible for it.
You can't blame yourself.
That's right.
You did what any good military leader would do in a crisis situation.
Hey, God will forgive you, but you got to forgive yourself.
There's no sin that God can't forgive.
That's right.
And from the way you described it to me, you're not responsible for his death.
I can lay in bed at night sometimes, and then I hear his family say it's your fault. What does a person do about that?
It's time to let it go.
The other one's just going to have to pay for it.
It's time to forgive yourself.
Because if you ask him for forgiveness, God will forgive you whether they will or not. But you've got to look at this, and they got to look at this. God will not forgive you if you don't forgive somebody else. How's that go? You got to forgive somebody else before God will forgive you, right?
If you forgive not another person's trespasses, neither will the Father forgive you your trespasses.
Yeah, that's right.
It's seen you out the window now. What's your name?
My name is Seth. I am a prophet of the Lord.
Listen, I understood your prophecy, but there ain't nothing me and my buddies can do. I mean...
Go to a man. The man's name is Jason Jameson. Sergeant Jason Jameson. Find him. He'll reveal what really happened. Ask him what happened on January the 15th, 1991. I told you all that the Lord told me to tell you. What these things mean, I do not know. But I know that they're true because they come from the Lord. The rest is up to you. I'm not very much of a people person.
You aren't guaranteed another second.
Is the key still in the car? Come on, I need you.
Yes, sir.
Where are we going?
Still in the ignition.
Come in. Hold it.
Who are you and what do you want with me?
My name's John Abraham.
I'm Craig Phillips. We was wanting to talk to you about an old army buddy.
Old army buddy?
A fellow by the name of Owen Roberts.
How do you know Roberts?
He's just a friend. We recently met and we just wanted to talk to you, you know.
About January 15th, 1991, is that it? What happened on January 15th, 1991 about some order that Owen Roberts gave, somebody got killed or something?